Hello everyone, I am Sonia Wadhwa. I have come from the Sanskar Valley School, Bhopal. I strongly believe that learning which is self-gained by the learner remains with the soul forever. Then what better than ICT in the age of technology can help students to visualize concept, learn, relearn at their own pace and test their learning through various online testing assessment modules available. I am a computer science teacher. I do lot of e-practices while my teaching to make it more creative and innovative. I use blogs, wikis, virtual labs, websites. I do doubt clearing session on Skype, WhatsApp and email. ICT is all about effective communication and using technology to make things clear, whatever things cannot be taught using chalk and talk method. A teacher can show visuals, so anything which is in the form of a visual, audio, video, something, a picture online, a PowerPoint online, everything comes under the umbrella of ICT. So that is information and communication technology. And if we teachers believe in cognitive theory of Piaget, that you know, learners will learn better when they use all their senses. So with the use of ICT, you know, we can make kids to visualize the concepts. If the video is there, they can play it n number of times. They can learn, relearn at their own pace. It's not that once the teacher moved out from the classroom, the concept will not be reteach. If they are learning, if they are doing online courses at their own pace, they can see the content 10 times, 15 times, go through it. And I think that's the great advantage for ICT. And where in, you know, we have dearth of resources in villages, their virtual classrooms and e-teacher is really a blessing in disguise. Thank you.
I am Ms. Megha from Leelavati Bai Poddar High School, Mumbai, and I'm here to share my views about the use of ICT in education. Education is a very socially oriented activity, and providing quality education is of prime importance for any country. ICT in education can definitely help achieve this. Our school, Leelavati Bai Poddar High School, has always been at the forefront of including ICT in education. And I'm really privileged to be a part of this school. ICT in education forms an integral part of teaching at Leelavati Bai Poddar. And I, as a teacher, feel that due to ICT in education, the lessons that we create can be creative, collaborative, interactive, and evaluative. There are various applications that can be used to make our classes fun, and the children can enjoy it at the same time. PowerPoint presentations, Google Slides, Google Forms, and even social websites like Facebook can now be used to channelize this into something productive. For me, holistic education can definitely be achieved with the help of ICT in education.
My name is Manu Gulati and I'm working as TGT English in a government school in Delhi. I think that ICT is a boon, especially for government school children. Children who are coming from marginalized sections of society, children who are from the migrant laborers' families, girl child, children with special needs, especially in government schools. They basically need ICT. The reason behind this is that there has to be something that motivates them. I feel that ICT is something that will motivate first generation learners to move ahead in life. It will make them more able to work with their future, to work with their in own particular field, they'll be able to work better. As a government school teacher, by integrating ICT, especially in teaching of English, I recommend that all teachers, especially in government schools, they must focus on integrating ICT with their respective subjects. My future vision in this regard is to bridge the vast digital divide that exists between the students of private schools and the students of government schools. To just bridge this socio-economic and cultural divide, I feel that ICT is one-stop solution to all the problems that our country faces today. Thank you so much.
My name is Dohita Parmar. I'm the science coordinator at DLF Public School, Ghaziabad. Today's world is a world of technology. we need to use ICT and incorporate it in our day-to-day teaching so that there's a visible shift in transforming classrooms into think rooms. The students enhance their learning process in the same. The teachers are incorporating ICT so that time is also saved. The classrooms are changed into think rooms and think lines are being incorporated, wherein critical thinking is being developed. Better participation of the students, concepts are more clear, understood in a better manner, smiling classes and happier classrooms are there. Thank you.
Namaskar, main Naveen Gautam, mera sambandh Himachal ke ek gramin school se hai. Mere school ka naam Government Senior Secondary School Mundkhar hai aur main wahan pe biology ka pradhyapak hoon. ICT ka use hamare school mein pehle to hame utna zyada pata nahi tha. पर जैसे ही हमें यहाँ पे CIT एंड CRT में अलग अलग वर्कशॉप्स में ट्रेनिंग दी गई और वहाँ हमें देश दुनिया के अलग अलग स्कूलों से आए हुए अध्यापकों और उनके द्वारा जो वहाँ टेक्नोलॉजी यूज़ की जा रही है, जब हमने उसको यहाँ पे सीखा तो और फिर उसी को जाके जब हमने इम्प्लीमेंट किया अपने स्कूल में जाके, तो हमारे बच्चों को, अध्यापकों को और ख़ासकर जो सोसाइटी थी उसको बहुत ज़्यादा फ़ायदा ऐसे हुआ कि अब हमारे स्कूल के बच्चे सीधे वर्चुअल क्लासेस के माध्यम से देश दुनिया के किसी भी राज्य में किसी भी स्कूल से सीधी बात कर रहे हैं और कभी अध्यापक ना होने के वजह से भी अगर बच्चों की पढ़ाई में कोई दिक्कत आ रही है तो भी हम वर्चुअल क्लासेस के माध्यम से उसको पूरा कर रहे हैं। तो मैं ये बोल सकता हूँ कि जो ICT का जो प्रैक्टिकल तौर पर हमने वहाँ पर एक बहुत ही अच्छा प्रयोग देखा है ग्रामीण क्षेत्र के बच्चों में, वो ये कि उनका कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल, मोटिवेशन लेवल बहुत बड़ा है। उनको अब ये नहीं लगता कि हम किसी गांव के स्कूल में बैठे हैं और देश दुनिया से कटे हुए हैं, बल्कि अब वो उनसे सीधा बात करके उनको लगता है कि नहीं, अब हम भी कुछ कर सकते हैं। तो इससे काफ़ी ज़्यादा फ़ायदा ICT का ग्रास रूट लेवल पे एक ग्रामीण क्षेत्र में, पिछड़े हुए एरिया में, हिमाचल में हो रहा है और इससे अब हमारे हिमाचल प्रदेश में लगभग हर स्कूल इससे जुड़ रहा है और हमारा स्कूल तो पूरे प्रदेश में पहला डिजिटल स्कूल इस ICT की देन है और अब हिमाचल गवर्नमेंट भी इसको पूरे प्रदेश में इम्प्लीमेंट करने जा रही है। तो इसका बहुत ही अच्छे ढंग से यहाँ पे हमें प्रशिक्षण दिया गया CIT में एंड CRT में और ICT की वजह से जो हमने अपने ग्रामीण क्षेत्र के स्कूल में बच्चों ने जो उपलब्धियाँ वहाँ पर प्राप्त की हैं, तो उसका आज हमें यहाँ पे जो मेरा यहाँ पे आने का लक्ष्य था वो था कि हमें यहाँ पे दिखाने का मौका मिला अपने बच्चों की प्रतिभा को नेशनल लेवल पे अलग अलग राज्यों के अध्यापकों के साथ। तो हमने बच्चों की ICT के माध्यम से जो उनके उपलब्धियाँ थी राज्य स्तर पे और राष्ट्रीय स्तर पे, तो उसको बहुत ही यहाँ पर प्रशंसा भी मिली है और हमें भी उससे मोटिवेशन मिली है कि हम कुछ और करें अब जाके वहाँ पर। तो ये बहुत ही फ़ायदेमंद है हमारे लिए। धन्यवाद।
नमस्कार, मेरा नाम संदीप है। मैं हरियाणा राज्य के हिसार ज़िले में राजकीय प्राथमिक पाठशाला डाया में प्राइमरी टीचर हूँ। मैंने अपने स्कूल के में बच्चों को पढ़ाने के लिए कक्षा के सभी पाठों को रिकॉर्ड किया है अपनी आवाज़ में। अलग अलग तरीक़ों से मैंने उसको रिकॉर्ड किया है, उसको मैं बच्चों के साथ प्रयोग करता हूँ। इसका फ़ायदा ये होता है कि उस पाठ को मैं बार बार बच्चों के साथ दोहरा सकता हूँ, मेरी एब्सेंस में भी वो पाठ बच्चे पढ़ सकते हैं। इसके साथ ही साथ हमारे पास जो एजुसेट लगा हुआ है उसका प्रयोग हम बच्चों को सिखाने समझाने के लिए कर रहे हैं। साथ ही साथ एजुसेट के जो टीवी का प्रयोग हम DVD प्लेयर के साथ जोड़ के, जो बहुत सारी DVDs मार्केट में है उनको हम इकट्ठा करके एक डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी बनाई है। उस डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी में से हम जब चाहें कविता, कहानियाँ, मनोरंजक करिकुलम लेसन्स और जो बच्चे देखना चाहें वो उन्हें हम दिखाते हैं। साथ ही साथ NROER से हमने जो मटेरियल डाउनलोड किया है वो हम बच्चों के साथ शेयर करते हैं। साथ ही हमने एक हर्षा नाम का एक डिवाइस हमने स्कूल में बना रखा है, जिसमें हमने स्पीकर को DVD प्लेयर, USB प्लेयर सभी के साथ इकट्ठा जोड़ के UPS उसमें फिट कर दिया है। इसके माध्यम से हम अपनी प्रार्थना को बहुत अच्छे तरीके से करवा पाते हैं। साथ ही साथ इसमें हम DVD यूज़ करके उसको DTH के साथ जोड़ के बच्चों को अलग अलग हम DVDs उस वहाँ पर दिखा देते हैं। शिक्षण में किए गए इन सभी कार्यों की वजह से हमें आईसीटी के यहाँ पे आने का मौका मिला, एनसीईआरटी में आने का मौका मिला। मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवादी हूँ एमएचआरडी का, एनसीईआरटी का, सीआईईटी का, जिन्होंने सभी भारतवर्ष के सभी अध्यापकों को एक प्लेटफॉर्म प्रदान किया है यहाँ पे इकट्ठा होने का। और दो दिन में हमने यहाँ पे सीखा है, समझा है, तो मुझे ये लगता है कि मेरे लिए ये एक पुनर्जन्म की तरह से है। अब यहाँ पे आके पता चलता है कि हम जो कर रहे थे प्रयास, वो एक अलग ही दिशा में थे, और अब हमारे को एक नई, बिल्कुल नई दिशा मिल गई है इस काम को करने के लिए, एक नए विजन के साथ। अब हम एक नए जोश के साथ इस काम को आगे बहुत अच्छे तरीके से बढ़ाने वाले हैं। भारतवर्ष के सभी टीचर्स के साथ मिलके ऐसा लगता है कि सभी काम कर रहे हैं बहुत अच्छे से, उनसे इतना सीखने को मिला है कि हम उन प्रयोगों को अपने स्कूलों में बहुत अच्छे से करना चाहेंगे। हालांकि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हमारे पास राजकीय स्कूलों में ज़्यादा ठीक नहीं है, लेकिन फिर भी जो उपलब्ध संसाधन हैं, जो ओपन लर्निंग के जो रिसोर्सेज हैं, उनको कैसे प्रयोग करना है, किस तरह से उसको हम अपने शिक्षण को बेहतर बनाने के लिए प्रयोग कर सकते हैं, ये यहाँ पर आके पता चलता है। एक बार मैं पुनः धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगा एनसीईआरटी का और एमएचआरडी का, जिन्होंने इस अवार्ड की शुरुआत की। हम सभी अध्यापक, भारतवर्ष के सभी अध्यापक, बहुत पहले से हम ये काम कर रहे हैं, हम अपने काम में लगे हुए हैं इस बच्चों को पढ़ाने के अंदर। लेकिन जो आईसीटी के माध्यम से जो बच्चों में जो नवाचारी शिक्षण का जो प्रयोग किया गया है, वो बहुत ही लाभदायक हुआ है। बच्चों को बहुत सीखने समझने को मिला है, बच्चा देख के और सुन के इतना अच्छी तरीके से सीख पा रहा है अब, जो पहले संभव नहीं था। केवल कक्षा शिक्षण में वो संभव नहीं था, जो आईसीटी के माध्यम से संभव हुआ है। धन्यवाद।
Myself Veena Nair, working in Bal Bharati Public School Pitampura for the past 18 years and teaching ICT. I am heading the computer department, and my main mission is to use the ICT for the teaching learning purpose and learning beyond classrooms. Right now I have come up with a project which is enabling students, or good to the last ICT. It is a tool for those students, for the special children who otherwise would not be using ICT to the maximum. So they use it so that with the provided ICT tool, they can use with the greater concentration and give the maximum output in a pen and paper test. With this, I have seen a great improvement in the performance of the student. And the entire project, what I have shown in the jury meeting, is being created by a hot set of students, which is otherwise, which gives them a platform for peer education, a sense of achievement, and commitment towards the society in a way of helping them. With this, I have seen that ICT is not being only being used for the teaching learning purpose, also learning beyond the classrooms, where we have taught the students to use camera for making social awareness films or any other competition where they are confident enough to use this ICT tool and present themselves as a confident human being.
I am Kala Lakshmi Das, working in Padma Seshadri School, Chennai. It's a CBSE-based school. I am basically a computer science teacher. I've been handling students from class 9 upwards, and I find that the students of this age group are little distractive towards the social media. So even people think that social media distracts the people of this group, but I feel that the same social media can be used to attract the students towards learning and make it more interesting for them. My primary objective is to make use of technology in education to bring about wonderful changes. By using Google Hangout, which is a free tool available in Google, we can connect more than 20 professional people and make the students and teachers to interact with those experts, by which students get expertise knowledge and they can clarify doubts with the experts. This is what the teenagers need. Apart from this, I opened a forum called Connect, in which 25 students and teachers are already the members. In this forum, I upload question papers, worksheets, notes, etc. for the students make use of it. Plus, I open a new topic in the forum, and the members eagerly participate in the forum. As a moderator of this forum, I am able to control the flow of topic discussion, and the students can be brought into the track to the subject taught in the class. I have also encouraged the children to participate in the collaborative projects our school students have initialized a project with the students of Reform High School, our partner school in UK. We have conducted so many online competitions for the school students of Reform High School and our school students, which had been evaluated by the teachers of Reform School and our school teachers. A Skype session has been organized for the Tamil Club of Australia. Students have demonstrated the yoga and Surya Namaskar posters to the Australian Tamil Club students. Apart from this, I also developed so many applications in Visual Basic, Java and C++, which have been already implemented successfully in my school. The one thing I would like to mention here is the CCE evaluation tool. In 2009, when CBSE introduced continuous evaluation pattern, it was little difficult for the teachers to comprehend and also to implement that immediately. By the tool I prepared, by the application that I have designed, the teachers felt it is very interesting to use and the time has been saved, and so they could focus on this preparing their lesson for the students.
My name is Mamta Narula and I am a commerce teacher at DPS Vasant Kunj, Delhi, and my teaching subjects are business studies and accountancy. I want to share one good thing which is different from what other teachers are doing. All my seniors, they tell me that they are teaching same subject again and again and they are getting bored because subject content is same but they are teaching different students. But thanks to ICT, I'm learning something new every day and I'm incorporating what I have learned in my teaching and I'm using those techniques and ICT tools in making my teaching more effective. I have designed one blog in collaboration with the commerce teachers of my school, and this blog is an initiative to make learning 24/7. Like right now, students, they are not coming to school, but whatever things we want to share with our students, maybe it is a video, maybe it is a CBSE circular, maybe it is some content or a question which we want to share, everything we are sharing it through that blog. And I have shown this blog work to my other teachers. I took a workshop and showed them the work which I'm doing, and they were very happy to see that. In fact, they showed their interest in learning the same. Many teachers in my school, they have showed their interest in making their personal blogs, and I have taught them, and now they are continuously sharing their subject material with their students. I also believe in one thing, that is, a teacher's mantra should be share your work, it should not be own your work. So keeping that in mind, I have created one Facebook group in which we have teachers not only of India but across the globe which are part of that group, and we are using this platform to share the technology information, technology articles, good videos or any ICT which is being used by some other teacher. They are sharing it in that group so that others can learn from there. There is no dearth of ICT resources on web, but what is a right resource and how is teacher using it, it is of prime importance. So when we are sharing things on this platform, it is a learning thing for other teachers also. Like recently I found a very good video called as Komal on cyber child sexual abuse. So I shared that in group, and that particular video is being used by teachers of other schools also, and they are showing it to their students. So similarly, if they find any good video, any good article, that is a platform where we are sharing it. So learning should be shared. If you want to grow, you should not keep your learning to yourself. Your learning should be shared. So whatever IC tools I am learning, I am not saying that I am expert in it. I am learning something every day, and thanks to the group of teachers which are there in my group, which are continuously sharing information with me. Learning is a never-ending process for me, and I am learning something new every day. And thanks to the teachers group in which I am, where they are sharing their good practices, and I am going to learn from them. And even I am also sharing the things which I am using in my subject, and we are learning from each other. So learning is a never-ending process for me, and we're learning something new every day.
I am Anbalagan from Tamil Nadu. I am a graduate science teacher, Panchayat Union Middle School, 1-2 Third Ward, Uttaramerur, near Kanjipuram district, near Chennai. I am using ICT in my school. ICT means Information Communication Technology. We are using cell phone, computer, and everything as a ICT tool. Especially, my school create a new ICT classroom decoration is very nice. Using projector and using cell phone, using connecting class, using web camera, and everything we are using for teaching. ICT is the best tool for teaching. Nowadays, all the students so eager to watch the TV or anything such kind of things. So we are using ICT in my classroom very much interestingly. All the students should participate in connecting class in my district. I am the coordinator of the connecting class in our district. In my district, we have four schools connecting with the connecting class. It's the best one. Every day, 3:30 to 4 o'clock, we connected to other schools. Nowadays, all the students eagerly to learn through connecting class. The collaborative learning is the most important tool in my India, in our country. I do lot of science experiments in low cost and no cost material in my ICT classes. In among my activities, our government should select me to go to Japan for the 45 days from Japan last year 2013. There is a training for improving teaching methods for science and mathematics in primary education. All over the world, 12 countries teachers only participated. I am only from India. In this opportunity, we learn a lot of ICT tools from Japan. So after I came back to Japan, in my schools, in ICT tools using in my schools, rather than all the schools using ICT. ICT is the most important tools for learning, everything learning through ICT. ICT is the most important one in our world. So learn ICT, learn everything through ICT. Thank you very much for giving the opportunity.